Hello everyone. Today here I am with another video of our daily minute series. In this video, we are going to discuss few questions that has been previously asked in the examinations. These all questions was asked in the IBPS A4 2017. Okay. So let's begin the lectures. First question is, if a soil has a pH 6.5 and this pH is lowered to 5.5, okay, the acid content becomes that dash times greater acidic, means when we lower the pH by 1 unit, then how many times the acidic nature of this soil will increase? See, when the pH is reduced by 1 unit, then the acidity of the soil is increased by tenfold. Okay, suppose here it is decreased by 1 unit, then the acidic character of this soil will increase by 10 unit. Okay. Suppose if it is reduced to 4.5, means by 2 unit, then 10 into 10, 100 times it will increase the acidic nature of soil. Okay. Next, there are different methods of seed sowing. Inserting a seed through a hole at a desired depth and covering the hole is known as dibbling, drill sowing, transplanting, broadcasting, sowing behind the plug. First, we will talk about the dibbling. In dibbling, what we do, we insert a seed through a hole at desired depth, and after that, we cover the hole. Okay. Generally, this is practiced in the plain region. Okay. This is dibbling. In dibbling, what? Through hole, seed is placed at desired depth, and after that, we cover the seed. What happens in drill sowing? In this also, we drop the seeds in definite depth. Again, we cover the soil and compact it. But in this method, sowing implements are used for placing the seed in drill sowing. In transplanting, that seedlings are raised in the nursery, and after that, when the seedling is ready, we take it to the main field. Similarly, in broadcasting, and there is a random sowing. When the seeds are in abundant quantity, then broadcasting is done. After that, sowing behind the plug. In this, what happens, sowing behind the plugs? Actually, the furrow is opened by the plug, and in that, seeds are dropped. Again, same furrow is closed when the next furrow is opened. Okay. Then, according to the questions, the question was inserting a seed through a hole. That will, the answer will be first one, that is dibbling. Next is, in which of the following tillage operation, organic residues are not inverted into the soil such that they remain on surface as protective cover against erosion? What you know, physical manipulation, your mechanical manipulation of soil is known as tillage, and the physical condition of soil is known as tilt. Okay, there are many tillage are operations, may be grouped into two groups. One is on season tillage, another is off season tillage. What is on season tillage? On season tillage operations means for growing the crops or raising the crops in the same season. Okay, that is on season. In on season also, we have preparatory tillage, means preparing the field. Suppose primary tillage. Primary tillage, just when the main one crop is harvested, after the harvest, we do primary tillage so that next crop can be, sowing of next crop can be done. For that, field has to be prepared. In primary tillage, activity like plugging, all these are done. Okay, you can say that the heavy operations are done in primary tillage. Secondary tillage is just done after the primary tillage is completed. But in these operations, to bring the good condition of soil, only light operations are done, such as harrowing, planking, all these. Okay, after that, there is off-season tillage. Means fourth off-season tillage means for upcoming seasons, the field is prepared. Okay. There are some special purpose tillage also, like clean tillage, blind tillage. What is clean tillage? Means in the clean tillage, entire field is disturbed. Okay. No plant is left undisturbed. Means that all are the plant residue or plant, all are manipulated. Okay. What is blind tillage? Tillage is done after the seedling or you can say that when the crop is planted in the field. Okay, Next, we talk about some tillage systems. There are two different types of tillage systems. One is conservation tillage, another is other tillage, in which we include reduced tillage or conventional tillage. Okay. In conservation tillage, if you talk about in conservation tillage, I think more than 30% of the crop residue are plant residue or crop residue are left on the soil. Okay. Just to reduce soil erosion or by water or after that, if you talk about reduced tillage, in reduced tillage, 15 to 30% residue cover are left on the field. Okay. And in conventional tillage, less than 15% residue cover are left on the field. Okay. Then according to the questions, our answers, again, we talk about the mulch tillage, in which stubble and mulches are left on the soil. So just to protect against the erosion. Okay. Then our answer, according to the options, our answers will be stubble mulch tillage. Now, there are different method of irrigation. Okay. The field is divided into a smaller unit so that each has a near bilevel surface. Which of the following represent this method of irrigation? Okay. Now, in this question has been asked from the irrigation topic. You all know what type of irrigation, how many types of irrigation are there. Okay. We'll discuss each one by one. Okay. First is drip irrigation. When you talk about the drip irrigation, we call it as a trickle irrigation also. In this, what happens? This method was firstly introduced in Israel. Okay. And in this, in the water is mainly dropped into the root zone, drop by drop. Okay. This is very water efficient method in this, which one? Drip irrigation. In this way, we will have nearly water saving of 50 to 70%. Okay. Water use efficiency is near about 95%. After that, we talk about the sprinkle irrigation. And this is also, in this also water is saved, but not as compared to drip irrigation. And in drip irrigation, even the amount of water can be controlled, how much water should be. See, in this water saving is near about 25 to 30%. Okay. And and water use efficiency is near about 60%. About 40 to 60% there is a saving in the labor. Okay. Again, if you talk about the this surge irrigation, again, after that check basin, after that flooding, what is, okay, this flooding is what? Just flooding means pouring water into the entire field, that is flooding. Okay. Again, if you talk about check basin method, in check basin method, what we do, in that we divide the field into a smaller unit. Okay. So that each has a near level bilevel surfaces. This is mainly done where the plant to plant distance is less. Okay. Then according to the questions, our answer will be check basin. Next question is duration of stress period in cattle is. This is good questions. You must know about these things that when you talk about the stress cycle in a cattle, there are four phases. Proestrum, oestrum, metoestrum, okay, diestrum. Okay. Now, if we talk the proestrus, that we call it, means you can, this is a proestrum, okay, then that is of 2 days, oestrum is of 1 days, metoestrum is of 4 days, and diestrum is of 14 days. In proestrum, what happens? There is growth of glaphian follicle, which helps in nourishment of the ovum. Or oestrum, during which female is ready to receive male. Okay. Again, we talk about the metaestrum. In this, what happens? In this embryo implantation takes place, again the last phase is that diestrum, where the development of uterus takes place. Okay. Then what will be the proestrum duration? That will be 2 days. First option is the answer. Okay. Now, This entire question was asked in the IBPS AFO 2017. Okay, like this in other lecture also or in other video also, we'll come with few good questions that has been asked previously in RRB, NABARD or any state competitive examinations. Okay, so you do subscribe our channel. just press the bell icon so that you could not miss our any video. Thank you.